So for the most part in this video series, we've been working with pretty much the same model, a fed batch reaction with a heat balance. And just want to show you now that it is also possible for power users in particular to build Dynochem models that are consist entirely of user-defined variables and calculate statements. So what I'm showing you here right now is a first order reaction model. I've got the kind of conventional Dynochem version on the right. So that's got the usual colorations. It's got the phase statement. It's a liquid. It's got the two violet colored components under the phase definition. It's got reactions in solution, the reaction statement. It's got the rate constant. It's got the asterisk to say here comes the chemical mechanism or the balanced equation. And it's got A goes to P. It's got the finished keyword. It's a very readable, tech transferable, suitable for use as a report form of model. However, you may find situations where it'll be your preference to declare all of your variables rather than using phases and rates, instead to write a list of all of your variables and write your own hand-coded ODEs or other equations for those variables. So you can do that using the variables construct we've seen. We used it for the yield calculation. You can just set up a list of variables. So here we have a user-defined variable called A, no initial value, units of moles. Crucially, the attribute integrate written beside A so that the software will be expecting to read about A dot dydt or DADT and solve for that. So integrate is a keyword I think you haven't seen before. Very important if you're going to make your model entirely from user-defined variables. And then we have the plot keyword. This can be either side of integrate, but I think you already know well what this does. Then we have a copy of that row for the product P. Again, a blank for the initial value, and then integrate so that we will be calculating dpdt. There's a blank line here. Power users should know you can have blank lines even in the middle of a statement, like we have here in the middle of a variables declaration. But I would say not too many blank lines, but you certainly can have them. And here we've just spaced things out a little bit so that the rate constant that's going to be used to calculate the first order reaction here is just a row below the declarations of the actual components we're going to track. So here we have given a value because we're going to dictate 0.1 reciprocal minutes, and that's absolutely fine. We're not going to be solving or integrating an equation for the rate constant. It's more like a parameter that we need to solve the rate equation. Then whenever you have variables, you'll have calculate statements. And the difference here is that these calculate statements, if they're going to be integrated and describing the rate of change of the components, they need to say dot dydt, or the older style of that is dot dndt, but dot dydt is more readable and my preference, introduced in Dynochem 5 and 6. So a dot dydt means dadt, that is going to be equal to minus K times A. That's the rate equation of a first order reaction. P dot dydt or dpdt is going to be equal to K times A, so with a positive sign. Finished is here. I should tell power users finished is optional, but very useful for properly delineating the bottom of your model, because you might have all kinds of other content below finished that you don't want the software to read. This is the mathematical representation of our problem. It's actually a built-in Microsoft equation format image. And I'm pointing it out here to assist understanding, but also to emphasize that the software won't attempt to read an image. So you can have images anywhere in your process sheet or the other sheets, and it won't interfere with the model being read. Images like these can assist the readability of the model. So again, make it more useful for tech transfer and information sharing. That's the process sheet how it looks when we've got a model that consists entirely of user-defined variables. The scenarios sheet, the main difference between this and scenarios if we were using the full Dynochem statements is, instead of the word solution as the top row in the header, we're going to have the word variables, because everything in this model is a user-defined variable. Similarly, if we had measured data for the amount of A, we would write variables in the top row of the data header. For chemical components, in fact, we have none. In a model where everything is user-defined variables, it's really going to be the user's responsibility to write all of the equations that describe the system. So chemical components don't really have a role in that kind of model. So it's fine for that sheet to be blank. Of course, if it was a full Dynochem model with statements, phases and rates, it would have these guys in violet underneath name and molecular weight. In Dynochem 6, you can actually dispense entirely with the components sheet if you have no components in your model. Then to run the model, it's exactly like before. You would run, of course, you can run in any of the screens, but to just repeat what we've done a good few times in this series, I'll run in simulator, and you'll see that you just get the variable name without the word variables in front of it. So we're used to seeing solution.p here. Now we just see p, a user-defined variable. Similarly, if we look in list phases, there won't be any phase or rate sections in here. There will just be a plain list of all of the user-defined variables. So that's what a Dynochem model comprised of user-defined variables looks like. And to build one of these, I would recommend you look in statements and model building help. You'll get the hang of it very quickly. And in the next video, I'm going to talk about combining these kinds of construct with these guys over here to make a model that is much more readable, but at the same time has the custom calculations in it that you want to include.